I am deeply honored to be here tonight to present the Actor Tribute Award to my dear friend, Sam Rockwell. Sammy has had an extraordinary last few years, from winning an Academy Award for his electrifying performance in 3 Billboards outside Ebbing, Missouri, to finally performing with his natural hairline in Fosse Verdon. It was about time the world saw it. I'm fortunate enough to have worked with Sam 3 times in 3 very different movies, ranging from big, giant blockbusters to is there even film in the camera or is this just a prank, indies. But regardless of the catering budget, Sammy is always Sammy. If you've been lucky enough to work alongside him and take a glimpse at his script, never sides, he's a theater nerd after all, and also very elderly, you'll see that the pages are like onion paper, worn down with loving examination and covered completely in notes and maybe some splashes of red wine, but like really good red wine. It's what all actors like to pretend our scripts look like. I mean, in 1,000 years, if archaeologists just dig up one script, let it be one of Sammy's, so they assume we were all such pros. He single-handedly has unraveled a century's worth of our collective bad reputation, allowing us to aspire to be better and certainly cooler in our going about this work. And speaking of his work, it's infuriating how prolific he is. And I'm here tonight to ask him to retire so that some other people can have a chance just to have a goddamn turn. I'm just kidding, because I'm not a man, so I don't care, but it must be very hard for the rest of the guys. I mean, I think there should be an Amber Alert or like a bat signal that goes off when Sam is working so that dudes know it's safe to seek out good roles. But the truth is, it wouldn't matter, because he has the goods you can't replace. He's like if John Cazale and James Brown had a baby and raised it on a hippie commune on the moon. There's simply no one else like him. Quick favorite Sammy story. 17 years ago, when I was working as a casting assistant for the late, great, notoriously hard to impress Mally Finn, she declared the most outstanding audition she had ever witnessed as Sam Rockwell's audition for The Green Mile. She described how Sam had arrived only to realize every actor's worst nightmare. He had been given the wrong sides and had prepared a completely different scene. And like a true pro, Sam told them he just needed a few minutes to look over the real side, stepped outside, returned mere moments later, destroying the scene, wowing the director and producers with a sensational reading that blew everybody else out of the water. Mally would tell us this story to set the bar for true professionalism and skill, and I memorized that story and vowed to become that actor. Years later, I met Sam on the set of our first film, and with bated breath, recounted this astonishing story to him in the makeup trailer. "Oh," he said, "oh yeah, that's a trick I do sometimes. Yeah, I had the right scene the whole time. I was speechless. This guy was even more brilliant than I thought. And maybe a sociopath, but either way, my hero." Sam is a deeply curious, generous, singularly brilliant actor who has spent his career supporting storytelling of all kinds. His dedication to independent film is clear by the choices he continues to make, always willing to take a risk on a new filmmaker like his most recent discovery, a Mr. Clint Eastwood. I'm so pleased to present this award to my favorite co-star, everybody's favorite dance partner, and a true champion of independent film, Sam Rockwell.
Thank you, Olivia, for those kind, amazing words. We've done 3 movies together. Good Lord, we've worked with Clint Eastwood. I'm constantly struck by how talented and versatile you are as an actress, and then you go off and you direct fucking Booksmart. Has anybody seen Booksmart? I mean, you know, are you kidding me? And then now she's interviewing Nancy Pelosi. I'm very impressed, and by the way, I'm available if you're doing a movie about a middle-aged neurotic guy with a graying ginger beard who, you know, likes sugar cereals. I'm available. My agent's here, Ava. I humbly offer my services to you too. Maybe a road trip movie with Laura Dern and Vera Farmiga, and you know, something like that. Thank you to the Gotham Awards for this incredible recognition. I have to say, it does feel weird getting a kind of a lifetime achievement award already, but I hear you loud and clear. I'm way past my prime. And I will retire the second this speech is over. That is if my old ass can even make it through the end. I'm only 51. My resume says 44. But with the right CGI, I can play 12. If you saw The Irishman, you know that's possible. I want to thank my incredible, badass team of people around me, Jason and Elise from Untitled, Rhonda Price, Liz Mahoney, and my greatest support of all, my beloved Leslie Bibb, who's playing a superhero now in Toronto. You're my superhero. I love you, baby. I'm proud of you. And everyone at Warner Brothers for Richard Jewell, and Fox Searchlight for Jojo Rabbit and Three Billboards. Thanks for not playing it safe and telling, you know, having the courage to tell these stories and give artists a platform to tell them freely. I've been at this thing, like many of you, for the better part of my life. I worked as a busboy, a barback, a burrito delivery guy before Postmates existed. And I did it all gladly to pay for my acting lessons so I could act. I'm proud to be an actor. My parents were actors. My friends are actors. I love actors. And the thing I take away when I look out at the audience tonight is there's a sense of community. I see my friend Yul Vasquez here with Russian Doll. He and I studied with the late, great William Esper, who passed away last year. And that's where I met my acting coach, Terry Knickerbocker, who's been invaluable to me for years. Bill Esper taught us the emotional responsibility to the text, and what we bring is behavior, and that's our job. And Bill's standards were so high, Yul can tell you, he demanded so much of us that when we went off into the real world, no audition was ever as terrifying as preparing for a scene in class. Yul and I also were directed by Philip Seymour Hoffman in a play at the Public by Stephen Gergis. It's called Last Days of Judas Iscariot, and I played Judas, and Eric Bogosian and I were doing this scene where he was the devil and I was Judas, and I'm drunk in a bar and I'm verbally abusing the devil, and he eventually gets me to commit suicide. And Phil said, you know, you guys are getting a lot of laughs, and that's great, and I love laughs, but Sam, you've just betrayed your best friend, Jesus, for 30 silver pieces. How do you feel about that? And I said, you know, really bummed? And he said, you're a danger to yourself and others. And when you come on the stage, I want you to make the audience uncomfortable. And I was always struck by that, and that's what Phil did. He talked the talk and he walked the walk, and he was kind of our North Star. And he still is for me. And one night he said, I see you guys are pacing yourselves. I know you're tired, you got 8 shows a week, and I want you to leave it out there. I want audiences to come to the show and say, how the fuck do they do that every night? There's a Billie Jean quote king, pressure is a privilege. I think about that. I think about community in a business where it's very cutthroat, do anything to get ahead, kind of blind ambition. I'm always struck by how my friends are actors and we support each other. And I think it's okay to be competitive if it raises your standards like Phil did. But I think we should stick together. So those are the words that I think of tonight as being uncomfortable, community, and what acting is all about, which is connection. So thank you. Thanks a lot.